everyone. This is Tiffany Schlain, co-founder of 5050 Day, and it's been an amazing day. We have so many screenings happening all over the world, and we love seeing all of you posting on Facebook and social with hashtag getting to 5050. We heard about so many inspiring events, and we've had great speakers, and I'm so excited to hear from Ashley and Marc Merrill that are gonna, they're in LA, and my co-founder, Julie Hermelin. I wish she was here with us in San Francisco, but she's holding down the fort in Los Angeles at Neuhaus. So she is going to do this wonderful interview. It's gonna be, as we've said, we wanna bring men into this conversation. That's the only way it's gonna truly move forward. We have an amazing couple up next, and they're both doing really great work at individually. And I think you'll see that they're both supportive of getting to 50-50. So, Julie Hermelin in Los Angeles. I'll let you take it away.
Tiffany Schlain. Hi, Tiffany. I know, holding down the fort at Neuhaus. So we're thrilled to have Ashley and Marc Merrill here. Ashley's the founder of Lunya Sleepwear. And previously, she launched and managed Momtastic for Evolve Media and was director of business development for Atomic Online. And Marc Merrill is the co-founder and president of Riot Games, the developer and publisher behind League of Legends, the world's most played online PC game. So Marc and Ashley, welcome as early supporters of 50-50 Day. I'd love to talk to you about why this issue, why gender equity is an important value for both of you.
Well, there's a lot of reasons why we're interested in gender equality. So not least of which is we have two children. One is a boy named Lincoln, and we have a daughter, Vesper. Lincoln is about to turn 4, and Vesper's going to turn 3 in September. And you know, we think that opportunity and equal opportunity is just an important issue for society in general. You know, we have faced a lot of resistance in our lives in different dimensions, some of which, you know, being entrepreneurs. And you know, we think that anytime there's sort of artificial barriers that are preventing people from reaching their potential, that can be an incredibly frustrating and damaging situation. And so, you know, to the extent we can do things to help provide support for people to reach their potential, you know, we think that's an incredibly important thing. And we look forward to a world where, you know, our daughter can continue to have, you know, and son can choose to do whatever they want to do and be who they want to be, you know, and sort of fight through whatever challenges society may be placing upon them, you know, from a gender bias perspective or things like that. So we're thrilled to be here.
Yeah.
Ashley?
I always think about this in terms of opportunity, right? So I think I'm excited about creating opportunities for women. Obviously, as an entrepreneur myself, it's something that I think, you know, the more women you see in leadership roles, the more opportunities you create. And I also think it's a really interesting way to create change on a macro level when you think about people trying to break the cycles of poverty, coming from single family households, you know, really being able to disrupt those gender roles that you traditionally see. And I think in my own personal experience and doing this with my husband and watching what that experience has been like, you know, as we both lead companies and how that affects our family life and thinking through that, you know, this becomes a really poignant topic for us.
So, yeah, we're thrilled about what you guys are doing.
Yeah, so tell us, I mean, so in your relationship, I mean, you're two working parents with children, you know, how are you navigating this within your relationship? It's getting a little personal. And maybe pre-kids, post-kids, how has that changed?
Yeah, kids definitely are a game changer, right? I mean, I think any parent will know that. Before you have kids, your life is sort of about self and self-actualizing and what you want to do. And then you bring kids into the equation and it is a complete disruptor, but in a really good way. I think it's they're exciting, they're the future, you know, and it makes you reevaluate what's important. But it also takes you to new places in your relationship in that you're exhausted, right? And you're trying to accomplish.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, exactly, right? Like, you know, you're trying to accomplish these goals that you've always had, but now you're doing it from, you know, maybe you've got a couple hours sleep that night, and And so you're having to trade off. I think with both of us, you know, and since we're both working and we're both running companies, it's really taken us to a new level as a team, right? So we think of ourselves as a team and really view our goals as joint goals. You know, how do we make sure that he's getting what he needs to be a happy, successful person? And I think he feels that same way about me. And then I think trying to make sure our kids are getting that same kind of attention.
And just to expand on that a little bit. So, you know, life is spiky. It's sort of a word we like to use where, you know, and while we're talking about 50-50 day, of course, today, we think that being a team and truly being equitable doesn't mean that the ratio is always going to look perfect like that. You know, so from a day-to-day standpoint, when Ashley was pregnant while getting her MBA, while working full-time and starting her company, you know, that was also at the same time when my company was growing quite a bit and scaling and, you know, had a lot of challenges. And that was an incredibly challenging time for both of us to figure out, like, well, okay, how do we continue to prioritize our relationship while still doing what we need to do, while being supportive? And that required a lot of sacrifice and change on my end, where, you know, I had to dig in quite a bit to be a lot more supportive. And then once we had our first child, you know, that required us both to sort of reflect and change how we do things as well from a time management standpoint. And, and I think that that's something that I think is really important for men to really think about, which is if you're truly supporting your spouse, your partner, et cetera, you know, what can you do to truly help them across whatever it is they're trying to do? And, you know, I think that that's something which oftentimes maybe is a little underappreciated. And obviously that's challenging. You know, it's been personally challenging in different aspects too. It's not like I'm excited about doing lots of household chores or taking the kids to school every day necessarily. But I do it and I love them. And you know, it's just an important mindset to have.
It's one of the things I loved about 50-50 in your approach was it's very inclusive in the approach. I think oftentimes people think about, you know, the women's perspective or the male's perspective, right? They're coming at it from their own entrenched point of view. And what I loved about this is, you know, you're viewing that there's an opportunity to be involved in your kids' lives for both spouses, right? And I think changing the way we talk about that and positioning that as an opportunity to shape the future, that now men are invited into that sphere more than they used to be. And I think that's an exciting thing. And I love that that was a topic that did get addressed for 50-50. And I also think people sometimes view balance as something that you know, okay, good, I've found balance. And I think the reality is we're human and we're ever changing. And so to me, to really have balance, it's actually much more about a values and goal alignment as a pair, because our worlds are constantly changing. You know, when we first got together, Riot wasn't even around. And he was starting that, and I played a very support role for him. And then our lives changed, and the kids came into the picture, and then I wanted to start my own business. And then we had to shift, and I think that's not easy. And by the way, like, that wasn't smooth. You know, we had a lot of bumps in that road. But I think we were both committed to a certain outcome, and we both loved each other and wanted each other to be successful. And we shared a vision for what each other's vision of success would look like. And I think because of that, we were able to continue to iterate until we got to a place where we go, okay, this is what the new balance looks like. And we know that that's going to change always, you know?
I couldn't agree with you more. And I love that term spiky. And, you know, we are always really conscious about what's the difference between equality and equity, right? Because things look different, right? It's not always scale. I mean, it's equity. What is equitable? What's an equitable situation for all, right? And to that end, I would love to ask you, Marc, you know, we have had some really fantastic men on today. And I'd love to know why, you know, where do you see, why is this issue important for men? If you're thinking about why is gender equity an important issue for men?
I think it's an important issue for men for a couple of reasons. So one, you know, I think gender, you know, roles and sort of societal expectations constrain men in, you know, in all sorts of ways that maybe people aren't necessarily conscious of also. And so, you know, if a man wants to stay at home and, you know, support a spouse who wants, you know, who wants going to be the breadwinner, whatnot, that's okay, right? And they should be able to do what they want to do and pursue the life that they want to pursue as well. Similarly, I think that it's important for men in the workplace to be cognizant of, you know, a lot of the unconscious bias that we may all have around gender roles and expectations or you know, what sort of great or excellence looks like. You know, I run a video game company, as an example, which tends to skew heavily male. Our audience is 90% male. And, you know, our employee base is about 80% male. And, you know, there's oftentimes interesting questions for the men and women that do work at Riot, you know, which are in the hundreds, you know, around, hey, is it better for us to achieve a 50-50 balance with that? And, but because we focus on, you know, we're trying to be super focused on our audience and our customer, you know, we don't necessarily think that 50-50 is necessarily the perfect way to actually serve the audience we're trying to serve. And, but the discussion and asking the questions and trying to find out if we are being biased in any particular ways, whatnot, is really important. And so, you know, we think engaging in the conversation is incredibly important. And, you know, and men at Riot, you know, are heavily involved in that. But we think men are all throughout the business world, I think, are becoming more aware and have been for, you know, for quite a while about our role in reaching a more equitable society, which, again, is not just an important goal from sort of a social justice perspective, but is actually great for the economy and better for being effective, right? Like, we want the best person in every role possible, period, at the end of the day. And so, you know, the woman that runs our platform team, which is an incredibly technical team, which has hundreds of engineers, is, again, a woman. You know, and the reason she has that job is because she's by far and away the best person to accomplish that job, you know, not because, you know, we're trying to, you know, hit some social target.
Well, you know, it's Tiffany here. We're almost out of time. It's so interesting. And I think, you know, it gives me hope that you're running a gaming company, a very successful one, and you're thinking about these issues. And that's how this change is going to happen, to have someone that's conscious and mindful and thinking about all of this running a gaming company is exactly what needs to happen. And I thank you both for both of your work and support for 50-50 Day. Thank you so much. I would love to talk further with all three of you. I wish we were in the same, I wish we were at a restaurant with a glass of wine right now.
Oh, I'm so jealous. I'm so jealous. No, Ashley, Mark.
Ashley,
Mark, thank you so much for everything that you've shared with us today, for a very personal interview. We have all these different categories in our discussion kits that you saw, Ashley, that people can still order online, because this isn't one topic. There's so many different issues that gender equity hits, and you really were able to speak to our home relationship category, and we really appreciate it because it's a personal twist on a larger societal issue.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you guys so much for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.